all you beautiful and amazing friends. Miss K here in my home studio. So today we're going to obviously start with our mantra, because our mantra is a way to get us focused and energetic to make something beautiful and amazing. So if you don't already know, our mantra has 5 phrases that we say to ourselves and motions that go along with it. So it goes like this. My mantra, I am positive, I am creative, I am mindful, I am amazing. I am an artist. And if you want to try it yourself, just rewind and do it again. So our mantra gets us focused and ready for our lesson today. I'm thinking it's probably best to start with something that's going to help us stay positive and help us share our love and energy with the people around us. So today we're going to practice a little bit of lettering and making a positivity poster. So you can make it really however you want and use the materials that you have around you. So if you don't have a lot of art supplies, simply find something that you can use, like it could just be a Sharpie or a pencil, and you can really get some dark bold coloring with pencils. Obviously in my studio I have a lot of tools, but I'm also going to show you some ways that you can make things really simply with what's around you. So I've got a big huge piece of paper, but again, remember, you can totally use newspaper, you can cut out letters, you can create with different kinds of markers, you can find things around you that you can cut. Maybe you've got fabric or yarn that you can use for making letters. But I want you to think about what you can use and kind of be a problem solver to find the best solution to the problem. So what I'm thinking is these positivity posters can go anywhere, because I'm the kind of person that loves to see things that inspire me. So when I have things around me that help me feel better, that helps me have a better day. So you can always put your positivity poster on your front door, maybe even stick it out a window so that people that pass by can be inspired to stay positive and kind to all of those around them. So I'm gonna show you kind of a top-down view of this positivity poster as I start to work, and then I wanna see yours. So to start your poster, you'll probably want to start with a little sketch. And I'm going to brainstorm some ideas, something like be kind or spread positivity or be awesome or just breathe, and something that can make somebody feel a little bit better. Now, when I'm getting anxious or if I ever get nervous, I always like to just hear it's going to be okay. So I'm going to just write down my words that I think and really kind of brainstorming how I can get my block lettering to totally fill my space, especially if I'm planning to put this poster somewhere where a lot of my friends are going to be able to see. So sketching is first. Next, if you have something to trace your letters so that you can see them from far away, like a marker, you could even use paint, you could use, again, paper if you want to cut paper around the outside so that it's easy to see from far away, totally cool. I have this giant Sharpie that I'm going to use today to trace and make my poster. Okay, I made mine a little bit more bold, but of course you can use anything to create this poster. That's the magic of this. Now, I just found some markers and crayons and colored pencils and things that might be awesome for me to color in really bold. So now I'm gonna go to town making it look awesome. Friends, I finished my awesome poster and I can't wait to put it up in a window or on a door or somewhere where I can see it all the time to remind me to just stay calm, practice being awesome and amazing, find a special place where it's going to mean something to you. Remember, you can make your poster however you want. That's the magic of art, is that it's special to you and you get to create it in the way that you can express your creativity. Now, because sometimes we need to just take a moment to practice a little bit of mindfulness, I'm going to lead you in a special sort of mindful, calming meditation. Remember, meditating isn't sort of like a silly way where you get to go om, but instead it's a way for you to focus intentionally on making the right choice and practicing your very best attitude. So get yourself kind of comfy, close your eyes if you need to, and you can even do a little bit of belly breathing where you put one hand on your chest and one hand on your belly and try to make sure that only your belly hand moves, meaning you're breathing from your diaphragm instead of up here in your shallow chest. So thinking about taking a nice strong breath and closing your eyes if you'd like. So think to yourself for a second as we do a little meditation together. Breathe in and breathe out. Again, practice one more time and make sure it's right from your belly. Breathe in and breathe out. Feel your toes take a little wiggle Feel your hands do a little finger stretch. Feel your heart pound. You are amazing. You are strong. You are resilient. And I love you. So let's keep creating together and stay awesome.